that's going to be a good thing. But the truth is, we have great guests on every single night. Tonight is no exception. Our first guest performing days can be traced back to when she was a mere 6 years old, performing on the East Texas Gary Jamboree. Honest to goodness, I'll never forget the first time she showed up at my jamboree. It was such a beautiful moment for Elvis. Actually, that is something, and it has nothing to do with me. But she is a singer's singer, and one, listen, you're going to know why. Singing Cast Iron Heart, please welcome Linda Davis. So glad you're here. How do you like our new place here?
I like it. I was just saying how homey it feels.
It is homey.
It is. Smaller, kind of quaint, and the crowd is great.
Well, there
they're closer. They're closer to it.
Yeah, I like it.
I do, too.
Now, I know you got your, one of the things that got you started singing was jingle stuff early on, wasn't it?
You know, I got to do a few of them, and I kind of lucked into it. I made a few friends, and they did a few jingles and got me involved. I did a few that nobody ever heard of. I never got any money for them. But one, that surprised me was a Kentucky Fried Chicken jingle.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Now tell me, just how far into the Kentucky Fried Loop did you get? Do you know the 11 herbs and spices?
But I swore to never tell.
Really?
Yeah.
You could tell me, but you'd have to kill me?
Pretty much. They're very serious about that.
Yeah.
But I do have a few of those secrets. But I don't have to make chicken anymore. We just have a lifetime supply.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
And you could probably take an offering anytime you want, all those buckets everywhere.
We use them for hats and stuff at parties. So they come in handy, a lot of things.
Okay, you and Bill Cody recently did the, what was it, the
Cerebral Palsy
Telethon?
Yes, we did.
Tell me.
Thank you.
Very nice thing to do.
Thank you.
What is, what's your take on television? Do you think think this is something you want to do full time? There's nothing to it. I mean, it's easy as pie,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
You are really good at it. I have a lot to learn. Bill was good at it because he does interviews all the time. And I'm pretty much a singer. But I like the challenge of trying to be the co-host. And,
yeah.
And I feel like I learned a lot, but it was for a wonderful cause. That's why I got involved in it.
Well, the big thing, the most important thing is to always listen. To pay just absolutely close attention. That's the main thing. More important than what you say is it's what the other person's saying.
You know what messed me up?
I'm sorry, what were you, I was...
You know, something that I wanted to tell you that's not an easy thing, you may be good at it, but we wear these lapel mics.
Yep.
So we don't have to hold a mic while we're talking. But the guests that would come on and I would have to speak to them, I had a handheld, and half the time I was going, so what do you think about it?
Right.
And they would be talking, and I would have the mic right here instead of there.
It's a fine art.
I was like going back and forth, and I watched it because it was pre-taped. I watched it Saturday, and some of the time it was like, oh,
so you didn't
Linda.
Have to go like round the clock for a week and a half or something? You pre-taped a bunch of stuff?
Exactly.
This is my kind of telethon.
Yeah.
I like that.
It wasn't the live telethon like a year ago they did it that way, but they changed it, and it made it a lot easier and possible to do a good show.
Yeah. Now, I know you stay really busy. Working on your own, singing with Reba on the road.
Mm-hmm.
How in the world do you be as good a mom as you are? Because I know you are. I saw you with Hillary today.
Thank
you. And, you know, you can tell when mothers are with their kids, if it's there or if it's not. And it really obviously is. How do you juggle all this?
Well, I have a wonderful husband who helps make the family thing work. And my mother-in-law and father-in-law watch Hillary while we're gone. They're our nannies, and she stays at their house as much as she stays at ours. Even when we're home, Hillary wants to go to grandmama's, which says a lot. That says she's happy and secure and safe and loves it there. And having family look after Hillary is key. That is so important. You know, leaving your children and you go across the country, across the world, it's just you don't want to leave them with just anybody.
No,
so having good help makes it possible, but we just dive right into being together when we're home, and we have a lot, like you say, to juggle, but we just pretty much do the quality time when we're home.
Good.
When we're off on the road, we call every day, sometimes more than once, but the phone lines are hot.
Yeah. Now, Lang is playing guitar with you, and I know you guys work together, Reba. Have you guys ever been together in this setting?
Not very often.
Really?
No, not very often.
Is he around?
He's
would you guys
there.
Like to see Lang? He's a wonderful fellow. Lang, come on. You mind?
Hey.
Lang Scott.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We've sat on the couch before together.
But not quite like this.
I want to tell these people here, if y'all ever ate her chicken, you would know why Kentucky Fried's in business. My daughter's over there. She can tell
us
about it. Oh, we're dogging chicken.
I have this master plan. As long as I can make them think I cook bad, they're not expecting me to cook.
That's a smart thing.
We go out a lot.
Very good.
You girls know what I'm talking about.
It's working.
You guys are fun to be around. I've enjoyed being with you today. How did you meet? You're obviously a happy couple.
Well, I've been talking. You tell.
Well, I moved to Nashville in 1982 in January and pursuing a singing career of my own. And I was here for 6 months and was in and out of a studio, the old Marty Robbins studio downtown. You probably know where that is, across from Slice of Life.
Right.
And I was going in there doing demos and trying to write. And in around, I guess, the latter part of June, I guess it was, of 1982, it's just like beautiful receptionist sitting there answering the phone, you know.
Hello.
Real tight.
Hello, may I help you?
Real tight Calvin Klein jeans on.
Oh, there you go. Which, okay. Yeah.
So
who
I noticed
cares
that.
About the chicken? Who? You weren't thinking chicken at the
time.
Wasn't
thinking chicken then. No.
He thought I was rich. Go ahead and tell him
the stuff. That's true. She had all these fabulous clothes because she was in the Miss Texas pageant for 2 years, and just every day just brand something brand new, looked great. And so we started dating a couple of weeks, several weeks down the line, and I ended up taking that ill-fated first trip to Texas with her.
Yeah.
To go see the home folks, which was great. I've learned every family member and their cousin and dog's name on the way
down
that drive. You know? And so we got down there, and I knew I was in trouble when the road ran out of lines where we're going. You know, we're on into the country, and we're like past the last city that had 5,000 people in there, and then we crossed the railroad cross ties that she called a bridge. Mm-hmm. And then once we got there, it was... She wasn't rich.
I wasn't
when I
rich.
Met her.
But I tell you, I have the credit I give to the community where I was raised. They all helped fundraisers and helped me get all those fancy clothes. So I had a lot of pretty clothes, but it was because folks gave them to
good
me.
Good folks
so
in Texas.
Very good. But I was definitely.
And good folks, may I add. Yeah. I love my in-laws. I'd like to go on record
good.
As saying
good.
That.
You're a smart man. Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, you messed up with the chicken, but you've done good with the in-laws. Well, so you're okay.
She's got an aunt that cooks great chicken.
Okay. So and you guys are going down to Australia with Reba soon, aren't you?
We are.
Have you ever been down there before?
Tell us about it. We've never been.
Well, the most fascinating thing that they have to offer, well, it's a great place. I'm not dogging it. But the most amazing thing is the toilet goes the other direction.
Toilet?
Yeah.
Goes the other direction.
Yeah. I mean, it stays still, but the water in the toilet.
Really?
Yeah.
Only you would notice that.
It's
going to be hard for me.
Do you sit and watch the toilet
here? Yeah, I just sit and look.
Especially if it's going to go around this way this time.
No, but subconsciously, after
that's
you know a few years of being near one occasionally, you get it in your head which way it goes, and it
Gary,
goes the other way.
That says you flush the toilet.
Oh, sure I do. Yeah! And I love your chicken.
Linda
Davis. Wayne Scott. Help matter for these folks. John Anderson's going to sing here in a minute. Don't go away.
When TNN's prime...
You see, the pigs are in a pen, and they're not able to get out, so the pen is my... Never mind, okay. Honest to goodness first graders giving us some wisdom right there, folks. Good stuff. This is a sweet moment coming up here. We talked to them earlier, and they're obviously very much in love and a wonderful couple, committed to each other. Here's Lang Scott and Linda Davis singing a beautiful song together.
You used to
would change the way you felt. But something's gone wrong and it's gone on too long, and I just wanna make it right. Tell me, how can I make you love me like you did when our love was new? How can I make you need me the way that I'm still needing you? You used to hold me so desperately, like you'd die if our love should end. How can I make you
job. Thanks, Linda. Don't go away. John Anderson's going to sing another one for us. That's great.
When Primetime Country returns on TNN, John Anderson is going to sing another one for us. You can contact Primetime Country on the World Wide Web at country.com, your personal source for all things country.
I liked it. Oh, hi. Well, it's good to have y'all back.
Thanks.
Now, we were just talking about his restaurant. You guys have been out there.
Yes,
yeah,
we
several
have.
Times.
Yeah?
And
mm-hmm.
it's good.
Oh, thank
oh,
you so much.
You, great. You can you cook are. It up good. I'm everything from the bread and rolls.
How
to
about
the
his
dessert.
Chicken? How's his chicken?
His chicken's great. it's out there. He's got these big barbecue, a barrel or is it
yeah,
a huge?
Smokers,
yeah, smokers. Yeah. And they cook it for like four yeah. days or something.
You know
it's
how
great.
To do it. And
well, thank y'all so much.
You got it decorated awfully neat, too.
Oh, thank you. Well, it's kind of rustic and got a lot of our fish trophies and things hanging around that we
their
picked
heads
up across
things.
The way.
I know you've gotten this question, but how come there's not a swing on the front porch? That's the only
Well, there's one on the back porch, and there will be one on the front porch, okay. and, you know, the
yeah,
next
I
time
mean,
you're there.
You got to be swinging if
oh,
you're well, there.
Yeah, yeah, we're swinging, but we just run on the front porch.
Okay. Okay. Well, that is a great song. And I got to ask you, I've always wanted to ask you, and I've never had the courage. How do you do that? How do you
I
do
can't
that?
I can't help it anymore. It's just a natural thing, I guess.
And Joe back there in the band can double everything you do.
Well, that's took him about 10 years.
Well, he's got you down.
Well, great. Yeah, I tell you, I'm so proud of the band. I know, and you travel with a great band also. There's nothing like the guys that have to ride with you day in and day out and put up with all the inside business things that can, of course, be a little sour sometimes. And those guys ride right along and keep those chins up and continue to walk out on stage and smile and play every night. There's a lot to be said.
That's you guys.
The band.
Yes, sir. You can't applaud too much for the band. And you guys do this together.
Yeah.
24 hours a day. I mean, when you guys are out on the road with Reba, you're just together all the time. Do you not just
drive?
Well,
we do have separate bunks
yeah.
in
do you?
The bus, yes.
Well, that's handy.
Yeah, that is.
Yeah. We have one
are you
child.
Sure?
Well, I've been to, well, never mind. I'm going to stay away from this. It can get a little cramped.
Yeah.
You know.
But we have our time apart. I mean, you go off to the Y and work out with mm-hmm. some of the guys or play tennis, and I go to the malls. I could tell you about every store in each city, the malls. It's a girl thing. What can I say? But that gives me something to do, somewhere to go. And
yeah.
But we manage somehow, I'll speak for myself, agree if you do or not, but in the same room.
If you agree, just nod, and if you don't, just shut up.
That's right.
But we have a way in the same room to give each other space if we need it. So that, I guess that comes after a few years of marriage.
It helps out. Okay, we got Valentine's Day just around the corner. Is he just incurably romantic? Does he,
No.
No?
No, I didn't. Lang can really be sentimental. He's, in fact, comes up with better ideas than I do. I feel very inadequate in the surprise factor department. But Lang's very sentimental and romantic. Yeah, I'm very lucky.
Oh,
it's just wonderful. Are you sentimental and romantic?
I'm probably not as sentimental as I should be, I guess. I'm very lucky to have a wonderful wife in Valentine, though, and she usually keeps me always ready for Valentine's Day. Jamie's been a real force in my life as far as the last 14 years.
14?
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Yeah, we've been hanging in there pretty good.
Thank you guys very much for being here. We got to run. I'm sorry. I could sit here and talk to you guys all night. Tomorrow night, we got T.G. Shepherd and Chris Cummings and tons of fun. Don't go away. Don't be a stranger. See y'all. Thank you. Airline transportation provided by Southwest Airlines, the official airline of Primetime Country. Go places, see people, do things. With Southwest Airlines, you have the freedom to fly. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. Gary's Boots, provided by Lucchese Boots. Lucchese, a legend among boots. Hotel accommodations provided by DoubleTree Hotel, downtown Nashville, within walking distance of Wild Horse Saloon and 2nd Avenue Entertainment District. Gary Chapman's wardrobe, provided by Dillard's of Green Hill. When in Nashville, check out the Wild Horse Saloon, featuring Friday night concerts starring country's hottest acts. Call 615-256-WILD.
Nashville Network is a service of CBS Cable.
Patty Loveless.